come with him, right?
I'm 68 doing 70, I prefer to sit down. No. Okay, the thing is that I'm so pleased to be back in London. I mean, I was here for 20 donkey's years with him, and I left at his taste, and he's... And I'm so lucky I went back home. They locked me up for 2 years. Then I come out and the struggle go on. As I said just now, it's been 16 prison. I've been in and out. But finally, at last, on the 9th of May, things change in Malaysia. Okay, how does this happen? I mean, my version is very simple. I was involved in the war room, both in the war room of the PKR, Parti Keadilan Rakyat, that is the party that's led by Dr. Wan Azizah, party been formed by Anwar Ibrahim. And also, in a way or another, it is a small group of us, three of us, four of us, basically three of us, Mahathir, Mat Sabu and I, three of us, was in another sideshow war room. So this is planning the whole thing. And then there was another war room that is semi-unrecognized, semi-underground, semi-illegal. So these are the three war rooms that work up together to develop the strategy, the thinking and the thought how to move. There's the war room that's going on, and at the same time, at every day, there are people thinking there's a lot of little group doing their little thing. But what are the factors that created the atmosphere, the ambience? My version is very simple. Victory of the 9th of May is a culmination of a very long struggle. It is not even months, it is not even years. It was the very beginning on the eve of 31st August 1957. That's where the struggle began. The moment the Mat Salleh left the country, the struggle starts. So that is it. So that's nobody can claim a sole responsibility for the overthrowing of United Malay National Organization. I have to mention the name as United Malay National Organization, but a lot of people confused, because they call it UMNO. UMNO is actually United Malay National Organization, was formed by the British on 11th of May 1946 at the Palace of Sultan of Johor. So that's it. The first important thing is that there are Bersih 1, Bersih 2, Bersih 3, Bersih 4, Bersih 5. These are the protest group that have been going on at the very beginning. But you must understand also the Bar Council, the Orang Asli, the Aboriginal people, they are also organized in one way or another. The civil society, the NGO, they are all working in one way or another. So there's a big, massive movement for change. It was not only PKR, it was not only Bersatu, it's not only PAS, it's not only... No, there are many other forces at work. So we have to recognize them together. It's all this is united together, pushing for change. Okay.